government institutions that train people and educate people in rebellion against God. America is full of government institutions that teach people a worldview that is in contradiction to the worldview that God communicates to us in His Word, the Bible. God's Word, the Bible, tells us that He created us in His image, and that is why we have value. But thousands of babies are being mass murdered on a daily basis in this country because the people of this nation discriminate against them. They discriminate against them based on their age and their size and their level of development and their location. Because this nation is in rebellion against God. This nation dehumanizes a certain people group, and this nation embraces a secular worldview instead of a biblical worldview. And so many people, they're not being taught inside these government institutions that Jesus Christ is King and that His Word reigns supreme. And that what He says is the true nature of reality. And that He reveals to us what justice looks like in His Word, the Bible. And He reveals to us how to be reconciled to God in His Word, the Bible. If the people inside this institution are not teaching you from a biblical worldview, they are leading you astray. If they are not teaching you the gospel of Jesus Christ, they are leading you astray. If they are not educating you about the abortion genocide you're living in right now, they are leading you astray. So I have to come here and warn you and tell you the good news that you don't have to remain condemned as a sinner before God. You don't have to remain a bigot who discriminates based on age. You don't have to remain someone who goes along with the crowd to do evil, but you can be redeemed. You can have your sins atoned for by the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came into the world to die for sinners, to bear the wrath of God on their behalf, to take the punishment that they deserve, so that they don't have to remain condemned to hellfire, the hellfire they deserve for their rebellion against God, but instead they can have peace with God by repenting of their sin and putting their faith in Jesus Christ. Because Christ rose from death, you can be raised to new life with Him through the power of the Holy Spirit, the one who comes inside of people and lives inside of them, possesses them, indwells them, and radically changes them so that they don't want to dehumanize people anymore, so that they don't want to murder their babies anymore, but instead they want to live in obedience to God's commands. They want to help the poor and the weak and the needy people. Jesus Christ reigns supreme. Jesus Christ is alive now. After rising from death, He lives in heaven now to be a righteous representative on behalf of those who trust in Him. But if you double down in your sin and continue to live for yourself, you will be thrown into hellfire. God will not forgive you, and you will be punished on Judgment Day. If you refuse to repent and put your faith in Jesus Christ, God will punish you for the ways that you have violated His law, because He is a good judge, and that is what a good judge does. So I must go into every place and warn everyone that God is just and Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the world in righteousness. And if you do not repent and believe in Him, you are condemned already. You don't have to remain condemned. You can become a child of God. You can become someone who's radically transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Today is the day to repent of your sin and put your faith in Jesus Christ and recognize that God demands justice, that God cares about justice, and He wants us to love Him by obeying Him. This institution that you are going to is likely not educating you according to a biblical worldview. This institution is likely leading you astray. This institution is likely not telling you that you're actually living in a genocide in which thousands of babies are being murdered on a daily basis. So it is time to come out here and tell you and educate you and wake you up and say, hey, you can't continue to go along with an atheistic evolutionary worldview that will lead you astray, and in the end it will damn you to hell if you continue to hold on to that worldview. You must abandon looking to yourself for truth. You must abandon an autonomous worldview, and you must embrace the revelation from God in His Word, the Bible. God has revealed to us the true nature of reality through his word, the Bible. And if you reject what God says in favor of what you say, your own opinions, it's going to go very badly for you on Judgment Day. So many people are running towards hell and nobody's warning them. So many people are murdering their own children and nobody's warning them. Nobody's educating them. Nobody's speaking truth to them. Very few people are speaking truth to them.
Is this abortion?
Yeah.
And this is like for like not having abortion?
Yes, I'm an abolitionist of abortion.
But I think the girl should choose.
But it's always the wrong choice to murder a baby, right? It's always the wrong choice to murder, right?
Don't have enough money to take care of the baby.
Not having enough money is never an excuse to commit murder. That's crazy, man. That is crazy. God provides, man. God provides. Trust in God.
It's our body.
It's not your body. The body living inside the woman's body is not the woman's body, and nobody has the right to violate the body of their own child. Nobody has that right. And if you think they have that right, you are in rebellion against God, and you absolutely must repent before it's too late for you.